السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اهتدى بهديه واستنى بسنته إلى يوم الدين. أمسينا وأمسى الملك لله والحمد لله لا شريك له، لا إله إلا هو إليه النشور. أمسينا على فطرة الإسلام وكلمة الإخلاص وعلى دين نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى ملة أبينا إبراهيم حنيفا وما كان من المشركين. اللهم إنا أمسينا منك في نعمة وعافية وستر، فأتم علينا نعمتك وعافيتك وسترك في الدنيا والآخرة. اللهم ما أمسى بنا من نعمة أو بأحد من خلقك فمنك وحدك لا شريك لك، فلك الحمد ولك الشكر. يا ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك. رضينا بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم نبيا ورسولا. اللهم لا مانع لما أعطيت ولا معطي لما منعت، ولا ينفع ذا الجد منك الجد، أهل الثناء والمجد أحق ما قال العبد وكلنا لك عبد. أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق، أعوذ بكلمات الله التامة من كل شيطان وهامة ومن كل عين لامة. اللهم تقبل صيامنا وقيامنا وقرآننا يا رب العالمين. اللهم احفظنا بحفظك واكنفنا بكنفك واحرسنا بعينك، إنك على ما تشاء قدير وإنك نعم المولى ونعم النصير. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن شاء الله today we have the last part of سورة البقرة. This part will start from the verse number 253 till the end of the surah بإذن الله تعالى. And we have very important verses from this surah, which is the greatest verse of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ayatul Kursi. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam give a special status for that verse, especially for the people who are seeking protection. Protection from evil, from shayateen, from satans, from envy, from hatred, from disturbance or worry. Ayatul Kursi, Subhanallah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sahaba give this guidance for the Muslim Ummah. So it deserves from the Muslim, it is worth for the Muslim to read and recite this verse in the morning and evening. Like we do every halqa, we start by reciting like a couple of pages from the part that we are dealing with every day, and then we make reflection upon it. And as I told you, inshallah, feel free to unmute yourself and ask questions. Just raise your hand before you ask, before you speak. And then, inshallah ta'ala, ask your question. We're going to have very organized conversation with the later. So let's start with the first part that we always do by reciting a couple of pages. If somebody wanted to follow me, we are in the verse number 253. Verse number 253. Until we stop بإذن الله تعالى. If somebody wanted to open his Mus'haf, we're going to start from Surah Al-Baqarah, the third part of Surah Al-Baqarah, which is the last part of Surah Al-Baqarah, verse number 253, if somebody wanted to follow me بإذن الله تعالى. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم تلك الرسل فضلنا بعضهم على بعض منهم من كلم الله ورفع بعضهم درجات وآتينا عيسى ابن مريم البينات وأيدناه بروح القدس ولو شاء الله ما اقتتل الذين من بعدهم بعد ما جاءتهم البينات ولو شاء الله ما اقتتل الذين من بعدهم من بعد ما جاءتهم من بعد ما جاءتهم جاءتهم البينات ولكن اختلفوا فمنهم من آمن ومنهم من كفر ولو شاء الله ما اقتتلوا ولكن الله يفعل ما يريد يا أيها الذين آمنوا أنفقوا مما رزقناكم من قبل أن يأتي يوم من قبل أن يأتي يوم لا بيع فيه ولا خلة ولا شفاعة والكافرون هم الظالمون الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه إلا بما شاء وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض ولا يئوده حفظهما وهو العلي العظيم لا إكراه في الدين قد تبين الرشد من الغي فمن يكفر بالطاغوت ويؤمن بالله فقد استمسك بالعروة الوثقى لا انفصام لها والله سميع عليم الله ولي الذين آمنوا يخرجهم من الظلمات إلى النور والذين كفروا أولياؤهم الطاغوت يخرجونهم من النور إلى الظلمات أولئك أصحاب النار هم فيها خالدون ألم تر إلى الذي حاج إبراهيم في ربه أن آتاه الله الملك إذ قال إبراهيم ربي الذي يحيي ويميت قال أنا أحيي وأميت قال إبراهيم فإن الله يأتي بالشمس من المشرق فأت بها من المغرب فبهت الذي كفر والله لا يهدي القوم الظالمين أو كالذي مر على قرية وهي خاوية على عروشها قال أنى يحيي هذه الله بعد موتها فأماته الله 100 عام ثم بعثه قال كم لبثت قال لبثت يوما أو بعض يوم قال بل لبثت 100 عام فانظر إلى طعامك وشرابك لم يتسنه وانظر إلى حمارك ولنجعلك آية للناس وانظر إلى العظام كيف ننشزها ثم نكسوها لحما فلما تبين له قال أعلم أن الله على كل شيء قدير وإذ قال إبراهيم رب أرني كيف تحيي الموتى قال أولم تؤمن؟ قال بلى ولكن ليطمئن قلبي قال فخذ 4 من الطير فصرهن إليك ثم اجعل على كل جبل منهن جزءا ثم ادعهن يأتينك سعيا واعلم أن الله عزيز حكيم مثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله كمثل حبة أنبتت 7 سنابل في كل سنبلة 100 حبة والله يضاعف لمن يشاء والله واسع عليم الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله ثم لا يتبعون ما أنفقوا منا ولا أذى ثم لا يتبعون ما أنفقوا منا ولا أذى فلهم أجرهم ثم لا يتبعون ما أنفقوا منا ولا أذى لهم أجرهم عند ربهم ولا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون قول معروف ومغفرة خير من صدقة يتبعها أذى والله غني حليم يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تبطلوا صدقاتكم بالمن والأذى كالذي ينفق ماله رئاء الناس ولا يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فمثله كمثل صفوان عليه تراب فأصابه وابل فتركه صلدا لا يقدرون على شيء مما كسبوا والله لا يهدي القوم الكافرين ومثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم ابتغاء مرضات الله وتثبيتا من أنفسهم كمثل جنة بربوة أصابها وابل فآتت أكلها ضعفين فإن لم يصبها وابل فطل والله بما تعملون بصير جزاكم الله خيرا بارك الله فيكم تقبل الله منا ومنكم صالح الأعمال تقبل الله صيامكم وقيامكم وقرآنكم يا رب العالمين اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا اللهم اهدنا في من هديت وعافنا في من عافيت وتولنا في من توليت وقنا واصرف عنا برحمتك يا ربنا شر ما قضيت اللهم اصرف عنا الوباء والبلاء والأمراض والأسقام إنك على ما تشاء قدير وإنك نعم المولى ونعم النصير Barakallah fikum. May Allah bless you, my dear brothers and sisters, in this meeting today, inshallah. May Allah make it beneficial for us to learn something from the last part of Surah Al-Baqarah, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. In this part, we have something related to the greatest verse of the Quran, which is Ayatul Kursi. And Ayatul Kursi, like the Hadith Abu Huraira, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that Hadith, that Shaytan himself taught Sayyidina Abu Huraira that if you recite Ayatul Kursi, the verse of the Kursi in the morning and in the evening, no one from the Shayateen will be able to hurt or harm people. You know? And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commented in that statement of Shaytan and he said, صَدَقَكَ وَهُوَ كَذُوب. You know, the Satan told you the truth. But Shaitan always telling the lying. Shaitan always is a liar. But in this case, with you, Abu Huraira, he told you the truth, which is, if you recite the verse of Al-Kursi in the morning and in the evening, it will be a protection by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from all kinds of evils, you know, envy, problems, issues. Ayatul Kursi is Jannah. So please learn Ayatul Kursi, memorize Ayatul Kursi, teach it for the children, and make sure that you recite it in the morning and in the evening, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. In this part of Surah Al-Baqarah, also we can learn from the story of Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam when he was in argument. with النمروس. This king that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him the kingdom, but he was not a righteous man. He's a kafir, he's a disbeliever, doesn't believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, because he was a prophet, he is a prophet, and Allah, he was entitled to deliver the message for this kind of people who are arrogant, who disbelieve in Allah, who give people hard time. You know, Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam and all the followers of Ibrahim should be like this. When they see something wrong, or somebody, you know, commit transgression against people, and somebody, you know, commit injustice in the face of the earth, you know what's going on? He will immediately start to tell him, stop doing this. And Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he went to Namruz and he told him that he believes he's a monotheist, and he believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he has to believe in Allah. And Namruz did not like this idea, the idea of monotheism, the idea that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of the universe, the idea that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created everything, including Namruz himself. But the Namruz said, tell me something about your God. Namruz is telling Ibrahim alayhi salam, tell me some attributes. So Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam told him that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who makes the sun, the one who makes the sun rises from the east. Can you make it rise from the west? You know, from the beginning of the argument, Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam told him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is the one who gives life for the dead people. But Namruz said, I can do this too, it's easy. I can give life for the dead person. And he brought two people from the prison. And he killed one of them, and he lifted the other one. And he said to Ibrahim, see, I give life to one, and I give death to the other one. Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam didn't like this kind of logic in argument. This is not right. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving the life from nothing. Allah created people from nothing. And in Namruz, you know, he gave life for somebody by saving him, he didn't kill him. But in Namruz cannot give life for people from nothing. He has to have somebody already existence in this life and then claim that he gives him life, you know. But Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam didn't like to go through this unfair argument. It is not, it's not logic. But he went to something more significant, that in Namruz has no way to argue with him. He said, look to this. Allah causes the sun to rise from the east. Can you make the sun rise from the west? You know, فَبُهِتَ الَّذِي كَفَرَ, was defeated, was beaten, was so, you know, ashamed by himself because he cannot do this. فَبُهِتَ الَّذِي كَفَرَ وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ. You know, Allah does not give guidance or success for the people who transgress or commit injustice. They could be, you know, transgressors in this dunya against people, you know, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove the success and victory from their life eventually. So what can we learn from this point? In our daily life, in our dealings with our families, in our dealings with our with people, with Muslim, with non-Muslim, with everywhere, when we deal with people, make sure that you do not commit any kind of injustice. You free yourself from any kind of injustices or transgressions against people, because you just to protect yourself from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this dunya and from the and in akhirah. And also, if you have some people in this world, they are transgressors and they commit injustice against people, don't support them, don't be next to them. You know, you always show your reluctance from any kind of injustice, so to save yourself from the consequences, the ill consequences of committing injustice in this world. This is the first point. So I will write it down so we can conclude at the end of our halaqa, inshallah, what can we learn, what did we learn from this halaqa? Free yourself, and I would appreciate from, you know, our brothers and sisters, children, students, if they can hear me, you can make some notes. So at least you can learn something, not just to talk in this halaqa, bi-idhnillah. And make sure that you discuss and argue with me too. And you can raise your hand to ask questions if you would like. Free yourself from injustice. Okay. What other thing that we can learn from this part of Surah Al-Baqarah? We can learn also from this part of Surah Al-Baqarah from the story of Uzair. You know Nabiullah Uzair, the Prophet of Allah Uzair, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested him with something so, you know, interesting. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused him to die for 100 years. Allah caused Sayyidina Uzair, you know, was a Prophet of Allah, to die for how many years? 100 years. And Allah resurrected him back. And Allah did ask him, how many years you think that you died, you spend in this death? So Uzair said, you know, it looks like one day or half a day, you know, sometimes from one day, yawman aw ba'da yawm, just one day or sometimes from one day. Mm-hmm. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him, qala bal labithta mi'at 'am, you know, you have spent, you know, in this time, in this death, for 100 years. And if you need an evidence about this, look to your, you know, look to your donkey. Look to your food. You know, your food, this is something, it's supposed to be, you know, ruined and spoiled and corrupted. But subhanAllah, Allah saved the food without any change. But look at your donkey. Your donkey is, you know, also is crumbled and you can see only the bones. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused this donkey to be resurrected again, to be alive again. So Sayyidina Al-Uzair realized the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he was amazed and astonished how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would give life for this destroyed country and valley that he wanted to, you know, deliver the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for them. When Sayyidina Al-Uzair went to that valley, he found the entire valley, you know, destroyed and no people. And I expect that most of the kids, they know this story from the cartoons, because they did it in a very good way, the story of Uzair. And subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala proved to Sayyidina Uzair how much power that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has to give life for people, to give life for things. To the time that we think it's too much, 100 years in our perspective is too much, you know, is so much time. But in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is nothing. We can learn from this story that if you are obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you have a lot of confidence and trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will, you know, shorten the long journey for you. Somebody is, you know, working so hard to achieve a degree or achieve, you know, some money from this business, or achieve this kind of success in his life. But you know, he just depends on, this person depends on his capability or his, you know, how much he have from power. And he doesn't pay attention to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's power. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could summarize and shorten this long journey and this long struggle for you to be in a very short time. 100 years in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is nothing. So we need to bring this kind of confidence and love and belief and certainty in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our life. Just rely on him and give love and glorification to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your life, and you will find a big difference in your perspective and your perception about this and about the understanding of the reality of this life. So the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam in his argument with Namruz, we can learn, free yourself from any kind of injustices, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is most powerful, and Allah has all power in this universe. The second story we can learn from it, that just be confident about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's power and rely on him, be obedient and submissive. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what you expect, what you think it is impossible in the sight of Allah and in the sight of yourself, it is not impossible in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, in this part of Surah Al-Baqarah, he told Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rabb, could you please show me how you give life to the dead? أرني كيف تحيي الموتى. قال ولم تؤمن. Didn't you believe? The Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, I absolutely believe, but I just wanted to see it by my own eyes. My heart can realize this very well, and I believe in it. But I just wanted to enjoy seeing your power by my physical eyes. Aynul yaqeen. I have, you know, haqqul yaqeen in my heart. the truth, certainty in my heart. But Ya Rab, could you please bless me by seeing your power by my physical eyes, my naked eyes, عينو اليقين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him yes. Allah responded to the request of Ibrahim alayhi salam, and he told him, just take four birds, cut them pieces, mix them together, put them in different places. قال فخذ أربعة من الطير فصرهن إليك ثم اجعل على كل جبل منهن جزءا ثم ادعوهن إليك يأتينك سعيا وعلم أن الله عزيز حكيم. سبحان الله. Put in, the mixture of this, birds that you cut into small pieces, into different places, and just call them to come to you, they will fly. And you will see the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in giving life for these kind of birds. So what can we learn from this point? We can learn, subhanallah, that we always trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's power. We always, when we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, don't make dua and you feel that I'm not sure that Allah will accept this dua from me. No, be very confident and be very sure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all hearer, and He has the own power, and He can give you more than you expect. It's more than you expect all the time from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told the Sahaba, ادعوا الله وأنتم موقنون بالإجابة. Pray to Allah while you are in the state of certainty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will respond and will answer your dua. Okay, some people, they're saying, Shaykh, I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for a long time for, giving and providing, granting me this and that, but it didn't happen. Remember, sometimes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deprives people from certain requests and certain kind of dua, certain kinds of, demands, because Allah knows that if this happened to you, it will be so harmful in your life. وَعَسَىٰ أَن تُحِبُّوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ شَرٌّ لَكُمْ. You may love something so much and the evil will be in it. وَعَسَىٰ أَن تَكْرَهُوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. So عَسَىٰ أَن تُحِبُّوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ شَرٌّ لَكُمْ وَعَسَىٰ أَن تَكْرَهُوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ شَرٌّ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us to think when we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah did not accept your dua, make sure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removed a lot of evils from your life because of this dua. Make sure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deprived you that, because if it happened to you, it will be, harmful. It will be something you cannot handle. It will be something will cause a lot of ill consequences in your life. فَادْعُوا اللَّهَ وَأَنْتُمْ مُوقِنُونَ بِهِ. Because Allah promised in the Quran, if you make dua, Allah will answer you. وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. Allah said, pray to me and I will accept your dua. The acceptance of this dua have different images, have different ways, have different forms from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometimes Allah gives you whatever you want. Sometimes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove evils from your life by the amount of dua that you had done. Sometimes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, delay this answer for you to the day of judgment, because in the day of judgment, it will be something more beneficial and more valuable for you. So at all times, do not be stingy to make dua for yourself and for people and for your family. It's absolutely beneficial. And Allah will answer your dua in a certain way, but just say Alhamdulillah ala kulli hal, wa a'udhu billahi min hali ahli an-nar. Kutiba alaykum al-qitalu wa huwa kurhun lakum, wa asa an takrahu shay'an wa huwa khayrun lakum, wa asa an tuhibbu shay'an wa huwa sharrun lakum, wallahu ya'lamu wa antum la ta'lamun. Okay, we're good. Are you hearing me? Everything is okay? Can somebody tell me that the voice is going on well? Huh? Barakallahu feekum. Taqabbal. Bin Allah Ta'ala. Okay. Now, what can we learn also from this part of Surah Al-Baqarah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about sadaqah, the charity, and zakah, and the economical system in the Muslim community. Remember in the last two halaqa we talked about the Surah Al-Baqarah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to teach the Muslim Ummah that this Quran and this religion of Islam is very inclusive religion. And it will cover, you know, all the aspects of life. It's not only in the masjid, it's not only something that we you know, use it for prayer and some spiritual feeling that we live in our life. No, it is a lifestyle, you know, religion, rules and regulations, how to manage our life affairs. Okay, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about the legislations related to the court system, legislation related to the punishment for the people who violates the limits of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah talked about the hudud, boundaries. Allah talked about the acts of worship. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about the buying and selling and economical system, rules and regulation. In this part that we are reciting today, Allah talked about, you know, what is the economical system of the Muslim Ummah should be built on. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this part, he mentioned about zakah and sadaqah, and how this charity is something really significant to build up a very coherent and cohesive community. When the people think about each other and give a charity and spend money, you know, and take care of the orphans, take care of the poor, take care of the needy, and take care, and you know, have this kind of cooperation and this kind of, you know, coordination among each other, it will build a very strong community. And this is exactly what the Quran come to do. Attasimu bihablillah, be united, think about each other, be helpful, love for your brother exactly what you love for yourself. This is the legacy of our Islam and our Quran. This is why we have, if you are in a Muslim community and you have some people, they are poor, needy, they need something, that Islam make the zakah, the alms giving, one of the pillars of our faith. 2.5% from our saving money, you know, we have to give for the poor people. You know, there are 8 kinds of people. We need to learn from them. We need to give them our charity and our zakah. Okay, so in this case, a Muslim should believe that zakah, this is one of the pillars of our faith. And he should learn that this is mandatory. It's not something, you know, you can do it or you cannot do it. Some people, they don't take it seriously, unfortunately. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you ask some brothers or sisters, do you do your zakah, brother? How you do your zakah, brother or sister? And they say, oh, Allah, I don't have, you know, a certain way to give my zakah. I'm giving a lot. I'm giving a lot of charity. I'm giving, you know, every time I give, mashallah, this and that, I give food, I give, you know, no. Zakah is not like this. Zakah is a certain specific amount from our saving annual money that you have to give by calculation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَالَّذِينَ فِي أَمْوَالِهِمْ حَقٌ مَعْلُومٌ لِلسَّائِلِ وَالْمَحْرُومِ. Ma'loom means it is calculated, it's not just randomly. If the Muslim, I think if the Muslim with this kind of money what we have, you know, in our Muslim countries and in our Muslim people, we are so rich, we have so much money in a Muslim country. If we are really people, we care about our zakah, the Muslim Ummah, not only in our Muslim community, and I'm talking about the Muslim Ummah all over the world. We have so much money. If we give the zakah exactly like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted from us, I think we will never have any poor person in the Muslim Ummah. But this is a capitalism system that makes, you know, group of people from the Muslim Ummah, they control the money and they have classism, you know, class people. They have so much money, they're rich, they control the resources of money, they control the business, they control everything, you know, based on injustice and based on persecution and based on dictatorship. And the rest of the Muslim Ummah, they are poor, they are needy, they don't find food, they eat from the trash, unfortunately. But why one saying that the people do not apply and implement the Islamic system of their day? The Islamic system is saying there is zakah in the money of the Muslim Ummah. It is legislated by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have economical system that based on, you know, giving zakah, free from any kind of cheating, free from any kind of embezzlement, free from any kind of, you know, what else? I summarized for you so many things related to the Muslim the economy, the economical Islamic economy, that it should be based on, you know, respecting the covenants. You know, a lot of problems when the people work together in business, they cheat each other. When you work in partnership with somebody, you will find a lot of problems. You know, this is the thing to when you realize that who are the people that you are dealing with. If you wanted to know the manners of somebody, just deal with him in business and money, not in the masjid. You know, not somebody saying assalamu alaikum brother, jazakumullahu khair, and we're good, and you are friends. You know, you go together, you wait with each other, yeah, very good friends. If you really want to examine the manners and the metal of somebody, deal with him with money. The money, you know, show up. The money shows you who is the person that you are dealing with. This is Islam told us, when you work in business, respect the covenants. احترام العقود. عدم الغش. You know, no cheating, no embezzlement, no exploitation, no, also what else, you know, no tatfif, you know, no cheating in the weighing merchandise or counting merchandise or calculating the imports and exports. All this comes in Surah Al-Baqarah to tell this is the business economical system that we need to adopt as the Muslim Ummah. Look how much, you know, cheating and embezzlement in the Muslim Ummah right now in the economical system. Look how the Quran, you know, told the Muslim Ummah to manage and to, you know, distribute the sources of the money justly among people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, if the Muslim Ummah have money, and this is public money for everybody, like petroleum, like tourism, like, you know, the money that comes from the manufacturers, agriculture, you know, industrialization, that is owned by the entire ummah, it should be distributed justly. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَا أَفَاءَ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ رَسُولِهِ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْقُرَىٰ فَلِلَّهِ وَلِلْرَسُولِ وَلِذِي الْقُرْبَىٰ وَالْيَتَامَىٰ وَالْمَسَاكِينِ وَبْنِ السَّبِيلِ. Every single person, you know, in the Muslim ummah should have share from this money. كَيْ لَا يَكُونَ دُولَةً بَيْنَ الْأَغْنِيَاءِ مِنْكُمْ. So to avoid having this money only between the rich, among the rich people. This is a disaster of the Muslim Ummah, right? That we experience, you know, not only right now because we have coronavirus and there are collapse and deterioration and declination, in the international economy. But before this, we have this disaster. We have this problem in the Muslim Ummah. So what can we say, what can we learn from this part, that how I can conclude for you, for everybody who is listening to me right now, to learn from this part? The money of the Muslim Ummah should be distributed justly. And we have to avoid cheating. We have to respect our covenant. No embezzlement, no exploitation, no tatfif. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَيْلُ الْمُطَفِّفِينَ. The people who cheat in merchandise, calculating and counting their merchandise, you know, exports and imports, and weighing things, putting, you know, less when they selling to people, they put less merchandise. When you have this merchandise for people, they'll put more. وَيْلٌ لِلْمُطَفِّفِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا اكْتَالُوا عَلَى النَّاسِ يَسْتَوْفُونَ وَإِذَا كَالُوهُمْ أَوْ وَزَنُوهُمْ يُخْسِرُونَ أَلَا يَظُنُّ أُولَئِكَ أَنَّهُمْ مَبْعُوثُونَ لِيَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ يَوْمَ يَقُومُ النَّاسُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ أَلَا يَظُنُّ أُولَئِكَ أَنَّهُمْ مَبْعُوثُونَ لِيَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ يَوْمَ يَقُومُ النَّاسُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Don't they think, those people, don't they think that they are going to be resurrected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for a great day, the day of judgment? This is the thing that the Surah Al-Baqarah want to cover right now, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. And also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, also from the things that should govern the economy, the system in the Muslim Ummah, that we need to respect the covenant and write it down, especially the debt. When you give some money for somebody, just write it down. Some people will go, no, no, you don't have to write it down. I trust you. Even if you trust him, write it down. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. إذا تداينتم بدين إلى أجل مسمى فاكتبوه فاكتبوه. الكتابة هنا كتابة يعني اختيارية, is optional. It is optional for the Muslim to write it down, but it is highly recommended, especially at this time, according to the time that we live in. You know, at the time of the Sahaba, the people already have this kind of honesty. You know, they have this kind of honest, they have this kind of respect for the boundaries and the covenants and the pledges among each other. Because this is the time of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. A lot of goodness and righteousness at that time. But at this time that we live right now, I think we need to write down everything. A lot of problems that comes among people because they do not respect and follow the traditions of Islam in writing down their debts. Anybody asking you for money, or taking money from anyone, you know, for rent, for lend, you know, for anything as a debt, just respectfully write it down, make two witnesses. It will be the best way to act upon Islam, inshallah, and to avoid any kind of problems and disturbance among Muslim Ummah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهُ. In this verse, in this part of Surah Al-Baqarah, we are discussing the longest verse of the Quran, which is Ayatul Dayn. What is the longest verse of the Quran? We call it the verse which is related to the debt. Related to the debt. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا تَدَيَّنْتُمْ بِدَيْنِ إِلَى أَجَلٍ مُسَمًّى فَاكْتُبُوهُ. What the verse number? Verse number 282. Verse number 282 from Surah Al-Baqarah. This is the longest verse of Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about the procedures, the etiquettes, the manners, how to deal with each other when once it comes to the economy, the money, writing down the debts, writing down, you know, any business transactions. It should be documented. Documentation is very significant to maintain the honesty and sincerity and the love among two people, and to avoid them cheating, you know, because money and business is a fitna, is a trial. You know, when people see money in front of their eyes, they got shaitan plays with their minds, you know, plays too much. But if you write things, you know, down, you will guarantee your right and the rights of people, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked in this part of Surah Al-Baqarah about the riba. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَذَرُوا مَا بَقِيَ مِنَ الرِّبَا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَذَرُوا مَا بَقِيَ مِنَ الرِّبَا إِن كُنتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ اتقوا الله وذروا ما بقي من الربا إن كنتم مؤمنين فإن لم تفعلوا فأذنوا بحرب من الله ورسوله فإن لم تفعلوا فأذنوا بحرب من الله ورسوله وإن تبتم فلكم رؤوس أموالكم فلكم رؤوس أموالكم لا تظلمون ولا تظلمون وإن كان ذو عسرة فنظرة إلى ميسرة وأن تصدقوا خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون. الله أكبر الله أكبر. ربا no. الحمد لله. The Muslim, a true believer, should be confident about this hukm. There is no any argument about it. If you have any doubt or any problem regarding the riba that will come to your life or your money, just make sure that you free yourself from it. Very controversial issue related to the home mortgage. If the home mortgage riba or not? Yes, it's riba. Okay? But
why the scholar, some the scholar, they said it's permissible for the people who live in the non-Muslim country that they can do something like this. Why? Because they said about necessity. It is necessity and for people to have this kind of mortgage. And الضرورات تبيح المحظورات. You know, the necessities will expiate or nullify what is forbidden. It will turn what is forbidden to make it permissible. And everybody should evaluate his necessity. Do you think that the situation that you experience here in America, living in this country, it is a necessity for you to have your home through this kind of mortgage or not? You are the real mufti. You are the one who will give fatwa for yourself. Yes, I feel it is a necessity for me, and I will do this, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. But even the scholar who say it is permissible for the people to have their homes through the mortgage, they did not say it is not riba. They say it is riba, but you know it is permissible for this kind of necessity that they have evaluated for people. But you know, nobody has no doubt regarding riba is haram. Barakallahu fiikum, taqabbalallahu minna wa minkum salih al-a'mal. And every single person has different situation. If you wanted to give fatwa for people regarding the riba in terms of their home mortgage, you have to listen from everybody, you know, one by one, you know, case by case, just to be able to evaluate the circumstances and to evaluate the conditions and to see is that necessity or not. Barakallahu fikum, taqabbalallahu minna minkum salih al-a'mal. We also, in this part of Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about the last two verses in this surah, which is so, subhanAllah, precious, valuable. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has, you know, received a recommendation from Jibreel alayhi salam. When you recite the last two verses from Surah Al-Baqarah, it will be sufficient for you the whole day. And don't be amazed when you hear that there are many verses from the Quran had different verses and have different recommendation from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and from Jibreel alayhi salam. Because this Quran is a bliss, is a blessing, and is a guidance from Allah. And we are entitled to take it for the blessing of our life, the blessing of our time, the blessing of our wealth, the blessing for our health, the blessing for our protection. So when Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say, من قرأ آخر آيتين من كتاب الله من سورة البقرة كفتا. If you recite the last two verses from Surah Al-Baqarah, it will be sufficient for you from all kind of evil and disturbance and worry and anxiety that a person could experience in his life. Last two verses. What is the last two verses from Surah Al-Baqarah? Can somebody from our beloved meeting today share with us reciting the last two verses from Surah Al-Baqarah? آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون. If somebody wanted to share reciting this for us, raise your hand and unmute yourself and start immediately. Okay, Omar, go ahead. Omar Sayyid.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون. كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله فقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين.
ما شاء الله ما شاء الله. Beautiful Omar, بارك الله فيك, تقبل الله منا ومنكم إن شاء الله. If there anybody can also share with us Ayatul Kursi from the attendees today, Ayatul Kursi, just unmute yourself and go ahead.
Okay.
I'm seeing three people, Arham, Tasbih, and من هاس. You know, go ahead, Arham.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم. لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم.
سنة ولا نوم. سنة ولا نوم.
ولا نوم. له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض. من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه. يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم. ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه إلا بما شاء. واسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض. ولا يؤوده حفظهما وهو العلي العظيم.
ما شاء الله ما شاء الله. Beautiful أرحم. بارك الله فيك. I have a quick question came through the chat. Riba is haram. What about the government loan? Government is given to small businesses and it is not refundable. Is this acceptable? Yes, our scholar, our senior scholar, they have fatwa regarding this loan that the government is giving to the small businesses. It is not refundable and it is very beneficial for the people who have been afflicted by the disaster of coronavirus, and inshallah it is accepted. You can take the benefits of this bid lillahi ta'ala. No problem regarding that, inshallah. تقبل الله منا ومنكم صالح الأعمال. تسبيح, would you like to say آيات الكرسي?
Yes, please.
Go ahead.
أعوذ.
Okay. تسبيح, it looks like she unmuted herself. No problem. We can...
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربي والمؤمنون. كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من الرسل. وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا. ربنا ولا تحملنا
تحمل
علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا. ربنا لا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به. واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا. أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين.
ما شاء الله ما شاء الله. تسبيح الله فيك. Can somebody recite the first part of Surah Al-Baqarah? Alif Lam Mim. Like couple of verses. Somebody to want to unmute himself and say it. No problem, inshallah. Can we all together, inshallah, conclude Surah Al-Baqarah by reciting Surah Al-Fatiha, the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah, and Ayat al-Kursi, and the last two verses of Surah al-Baqarah, bi-idhillahi ta'ala, and tomorrow we're going to work in Surah al-Imran, bi-idhillahi ta'ala. Can everybody unmute himself and recite with me together, inshallah, like, you know, group reading. Everybody unmute yourself. We're going to recite together, inshallah, for the blessing of this day, bi-idhillahi ta'ala.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الرحمن الرحيم. مالك يوم الدين. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ألف لام ميم. ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه. هدى للمتقين.
الذين يؤمنون بالغيب ويقيمون الصلاة ومما
Okay, guys, because I'm seeing that, the whole voice is, I'm seeing that there are some disruption in the sound. Let me say it so everybody can listen to a clear voice, inshallah ta'ala. Alif Lam Mim. ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين الذين يؤمنون بالغيب ويقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون والذين يؤمنون بما أنزل إليك وما أنزل من قبلك وبالآخرة هم يوقنون أولئك على هدى من ربهم وأولئك هم المفلحون الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه إلا بما شاء وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض ولا يئوده حفظهما وهو العلي العظيم آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت اللهم تقبل صيامنا وقيامنا وقرآننا واغفر ذنوبنا رب تقبل توبتنا واغسل حوبتنا واسلل سخائم صدورنا اللهم إنا نسألك قبل الموت توبة وعند الموت شهادة وبعد الموت جنة ونعيما اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات اللهم اغفر لآبائنا وأمهاتنا اللهم اعتق رقابنا من النار اللهم اعتق رقابنا ورقاب آبائنا ورقاب أمهاتنا من النار اللهم اعتق رقابنا ورقاب آبائنا وأمهاتنا من النار اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل اللهم اضرب علينا سرادقات عرشك وأسكننا دوائر لطفك اللهم حصنا بكتابك وآياتك وأعذنا بأسمائك وكلماتك وصفاتك من شر الأشرار وكيد الفجار وشر ما تجري به الأقدار بالليل والنهار يا عزيز يا غفار اللهم ارزقنا الإيمان بحفظك إيمانا تسكن به قلوبنا من هم الرزق وخوف الخلق اللهم ارزقنا الإيمان بحفظك إيمانا تسكن به قلوبنا من هم الرزق تسكن به قلوبنا من خوف الخلق. اللهم عافنا في أبداننا، عافنا في أسماعنا، عافنا في أبصارنا. اللهم ارزقنا الحلال وبارك لنا فيه، باعد بيننا وبين الحرام كما باعدت بين المشرق والمغرب. اللهم إنا نسألك اليمن والبركة، ونعوذ بك من الشؤم والهلكة. اللهم لا يأتي بالحسنات إلا أنت، ولا يذهب السيئات إلا أنت، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بك. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا، وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. اللهم احفظنا بحفظك، واكنفنا بكنفك، واحرسنا بعينك. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا، وانفعنا بما علمتنا، وزدنا علما. اللهم ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا، اللهم ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا، ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا. اللهم الطف بنا فيما جرت به المقادير، الطف بنا في قضائك وقدرك، ارحمنا وانصرنا واهدنا وارزقنا وتب علينا، إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. بارك لنا يا ربنا في أموالنا وفي أولادنا وزوجاتنا، أنزل بركات السماء والأرض علينا، فك الحصار عنا، ارفع عنا البلاء والأمراض والأسقام. نعوذ بك من الهم والحزن، نعوذ بك من العجز والكسل، نعوذ بك من الجبن والبخل، نعوذ بك من غلبة الدين وقهر الرجال. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم، وسلم تسليما كثيرا. بارك الله فيكم، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. See you tomorrow إن شاء الله.
شكرا.